Guys, here is the part 3 of the tutorial on how to make computer run faster.
MCCS, transforming experience, presenting opportunities.
Tip number 11, do not delete Prefetch files and do not disable Prefetch and SuperFetch or system maintenance on HDD, but you can disable them if using SSD or they are auto disabled while using SSD. Let me explain it for you. You might have heard that deleting the Prefetch files and disabling Prefetch and SuperFetch actually result in less boot time and more free memory because Windows loads Prefetch information for all of the programs you have ever installed on your computer into memory automatically, filling your RAM with unused data. So that delete the contents of Prefetch files on a regular basis to keep your memory free from unused data. But guys, I'm confident this is not a true claim. I have reasons for this. Let me give my reasons in the form of questions and answers, and then you yourself decide whether you want to delete or not to delete the Prefetch files and disable Prefetch and SuperFetch. What are Prefetch and SuperFetch? Prefetch is a Windows feature that helps you to open your most frequently used applications by reducing their loading time. So Prefetch is basically an important time-saving tool. SuperFetch, on the other hand, determines which applications you will launch and then loads up all the necessary files and data into the memory or RAM. Both Prefetch and SuperFetch are actively working every second behind your computer to make your computer run faster. What do Prefetch and SuperFetch do? These features make cache files of all your applications you have used before, so that applications can be opened in much less time. Does deleting the Prefetch files speed up the Windows? No. If you delete them, there will actually be an increase of the loading time while opening any app. Is it safe to delete Prefetch files and disable both Prefetch and SuperFetch? Yes, our recommendation is that if your system is running well, leave them on. If you have issues with high HDD usage, high RAM usage, then try turning them off and see if it helps. Otherwise, turn them back on. In other words, if your HDD runs at 100% for a few minutes every time you start or restart your computer, SuperFetch could be the culprit. When should you enable or disable Prefetch and SuperFetch? Disable them if you are using a solid state drive SSD, or they are sometimes auto-disabled while using SSD, but enable them if you are using traditional HDD. Now, if you still want to delete the Prefetch files, we recommend to delete them once in 6 months or once in a year. Okay, let's do it. How to delete the Prefetch files? First, let's learn how to disable the SuperFetch. You go to Start Search, you type Service. You click on the top result, and this will be appear. You come down and find the SysMain here. Double click on SysMain. Here it is automatic. You can disable it from here. Then you click on stop. Then you click on apply. Then you click on OK. It was about disabling the SuperFetch. Now let's go to disable the SuperFetch from the register editor and also disable the Prefetch. You go to start search. Either you write REG edit. On the top result there will be registering editor. You click on this, or you can write run, enter, and write REG edit, enter. You will see this window, the register editor. Before you perform any changes in the registry editor, I highly recommend that you export a registry editor backup from the file menu. Click on the export option and save the file, just in case something goes wrong. In here, you click on key local machine, expand it, then come here and choose system. Expand the system and choose current control set. Expand it. Then you select control. Expand the control folder. And you come down to find session manager. Yeah, here, this is the session manager. Expand it. In here, you select the memory management. You expand it. And you can use the prefetch parameters. In here, there is option enable prefetch and enable superfetch. You double click on it. If you see here on the base hexadecimal, the value is 3. So what does it mean? 0 means disabled. It won't start with PC. 1, automatic start. It will boot as soon as possible. 2. Automatic delete start. It will start after the boot up process is finished. 3. Manual start. You start it yourself when you feel like it. So if you want to disable it, you just put 0. Then you click on OK. Right? So I cancel it because I don't want to disable it. Then you go to the prefetch. You click on it. And you type a 0 here and click on OK. Okay guys, now to delete the prefetch files, go to start search, write run, enter, write prefetch. Enter. The prefetch folder is open for you and these are the files which are stored in prefetch folder. You can select them all by Ctrl A and right click and delete them. You click on yes. Okay, when you see this kind of a pop-up, okay, that's not a problem. Just put a check mark on do this for all current items and click on skip. You're done. Tip number 12. Empty the system storage. Hey guys, this is something very crazy. You can free up huge space on your C drive, which results a max performance in your Windows computer, and as well as you do not need to extend the C drive. How is a file saved in the system storage? There are some specific folders located in C drive by default. Either a user saves the files in these folders, or by default the system saves them as backups automatically. These applications are videos editors, CorelDRAW, some messengers and etc. In result, it is complicated to manage the original and auto-saved files. One of the reasons the drive is running low on space becomes noticeable after filling up around 70% of the total storage capacity. And finally, you decide to extend the C drive, though it is not needed. Thus, it is a good idea to move or save all your necessary files into any other drive to be able to do a cleanup of these folders frequently and free up more space on the C drive for speeding up your computer. If we delete a file folder belonging to any application in use, will it be recreated? Yes, it can be recreated when you open the application, but the old files will no longer be there. How often should you clean up the system storage? Clean up the system storage on a monthly to a quarterly basis or anytime you need it. Now let's do it practically. To empty the system storage, you go to Start, Setting, System, Storage. Here in this window, first of all, you have to turn this on. Storage Sense can automatically free up space by getting rid of files you don't need, like temporary files and content in your recycle bin. Always keep it on. If you scroll down and also you click on show more categories, these are the folders which are the options for us to either delete them or we keep them. From these folders, the first one is documents. As you see in my local disk C drive, 117 GB already used and only 42.3 GB is free. Here you can also see that in C drive only 42.2 GB is remaining and the total of the storage is 159. First of all, you have to click on this documents and go to view documents. This document folder saves the files and backups of the applications you use and many more other files stored here which are not necessary at all. For example, if you see here, there is Wondershare Filmora 9 that I'm using. This is the video editor. If you come here and click on recorded, so these are the videos backup files which are not needed anymore because I already have them and exported to my F drive or a D drive. So if I delete them, there will be more space in my C drive. So if I go back, if one of these folders is deleted, will it be created if the application is in use? Of course, that can be recreated. For example, now you see here, this is Viber downloads. The Viber messenger also saves the files here. If I right click and delete it from here, and I open the Viber messenger, this folder will be recreated here, but there will not be the old files in it. You see, Viber downloads folder is recreated because it is opening now. Before you're gonna delete the files and folders and documents folder, you have to make sure that if you have any files here which are necessary and you have to save or move them to your other drive, then you can delete all of them. The files which are here, I have already saved them in my D drive or in my F drive. I don't need these files anymore. I use Control A, right click, and we delete it. So when you see this, there is a pop-up. Do you want to permanently delete them? Yes, click on yes. Time to time, these folders are recreated. Any application you open, the folder is created here. So maybe we have used many applications in past time and the folders are still here. So if we delete them, we will have more space for our C drive. Okay, there is a pop-up message. The action can't be completed because the file is open in F recorder. In F recorder of Wondershare Filmora 9, and it is currently running. So I put a check mark here and click on escape. Okay, it is done. Let's go to the system storage again. So the next folder that we are going to empty is leave system and reserve app and features temporary files. Click on temporary files. It is scanning now. Select all of them. Click on remove files. Okay, it is done. Go back. desktop. In desktop, I use only the shortcuts of the files which are stored in my D drive and F drive. I do not need to delete any file from here. From the mail also, I do not need any email to be deleted. Leave these others, temporary files we have deleted. So I click on pictures. Okay, videos. I use Alt Tab to change the page. So page videos finished documents is now 102 MB here. Okay, one drive 62 MB. So this is music. So I don't want the music. I delete all of them. So any folder you want, you can keep. Otherwise, you can delete them. But the only folders that you should not delete them are, one is system and reserved. You should not delete this folder. Leave it as it is. And you should not delete the other folders. Leave it as it is. These two folders are very important. So maps, I leave it. Other people, okay, we need it. So it is done for the storage. Now if you see here, 69.5 GB used, 90 GB is free. If I go to my this PC, I have much more space here in on my C drive. I don't need to extend my C drive anymore. Now instead of 42 GB, I have 90 GB. To do this action, I highly recommend you to always save your file on D drive, or if you do not have the other drives, you can make a new partition and save your necessary files in it, and always keep the C drive cleaned. That's it guys, good luck. If you still didn't watch the part 1 and part 2 of the video, just type MCCS consultancy on any browser search and click on MCCS consultancy YouTube channel. Click on videos, scroll down in app and watch the part 1 and 2 of the video. Thank you and have a nice day.